Use Grammarly for education for free using IITK mail ID. You will have to create an account in Grammarly using your IITK mail ID. So for that, let's head over to your browser. That's Google Chrome, and search for Grammarly Enterprise Login. Okay. So first one is basically an ad. Let's head over to the first result, that is Grammarly Enterprise sign in. Okay, so this is basically a login, but we are signing up for the first time, that is creating an account. So to create account, we will head over to sign up. Okay. Now we will type in our name. And then we will type in our email ID. That's basically IITK mail ID. So suppose your IITK mail ID is something, say xyz @iitk.ac.in. So you will type in your IITK mail ID, whatever is your IITK mail ID. And after that, you will set a password for your Grammarly account. And then you will click on sign up. After clicking on sign up, you will basically get a mail from Grammarly that will have a verification process which will verify that the email that you have provided here belongs to you. So once you do the verification process, you will get the Grammarly for Education license on your own till the time you are a student. Okay, so let me just show you how Grammarly for Education looks once you've created an account. You will go to grammarly.com, and then after that you will sign in using the same credentials that you've created the account. Okay, so now you can see that basically when you will be opening it for the first time, you will be having just a demo content here and option here. So you can basically click on a new option and just type in your content here. Or you can basically take content from somewhere else and put it over here using Control V. So suppose I'm taking this content by using Control C and I'm pasting it here, Control V. So you can see this is basically how it works. And now whatever is the suggestions that you can get here, and you can basically put things according to your goal, whether your audience is expert, your audience is general, you according to formality, if you are your tone has to be formal, informal, or neutral. You can also set it according to domain, that's whether you are writing it for academic purpose, business purpose, or as a general, or as an email, or some creative writing, or other things. You can also set the tone. That is, you want your email to be sounding confident, joyful, optimistic, friendly, urgent, analytical, respectful, or whatever. Okay. And then click on done. Then you will basically get suggestions according to the goals that you would have set. And whatever are the errors in your content, you will get all the suggestions here. And you can basically save your content using giving a title to your document, and you can all the documents get saved in cloud, so you can access it anywhere using your same Grammarly credentials. Now let me show to you the apps that you get under Grammarly for Education. So Grammarly apps include these four apps. So the first app is Grammarly for Windows. If you're using another operating system, then you will be having Grammarly for that particular operating system here. So when you will click on install, then a setup will download, which's around 15 MB. So once you click on the setup and installed it, so after installing, it will be something, some application like this, Grammarly. It will head over in your all apps corner, and you can open it and sign in. So the way that you have accessed Grammarly here, you can access Grammarly in the very same way using this application that in your operating system as a app, not just as a browser site. So you can see that the same content data I have assessed here, the same I'm assessing using this application. And I can basically upload, or basically I can download my content using this download feature, and it will get downloaded as a Word document. So you can see that it's saving as a Word document. Okay. I can also download it using here also. When I will click on here, so that content will be downloaded as a document file, that is a Word file basically. Okay, now let me get to the second application, that is Grammarly for Chrome. If you're using another browser, then you will be having here Grammarly for that particular browser. So that is basically an extension to your browser. So when you will click on install it for the first time, you will head to the extensions of that particular browser and click on add to Chrome, and then your Grammarly will be added to Chrome. In this particular site, it's not supported. Okay, so you will be having some pane like this, and you will be and this extension is not just for clicking on new document and writing a document or heading to the Grammarly by just clicking on my Grammarly. This extension is much more than just heading to grammarly.com. While you are writing your email or writing messages in your WhatsApp or Facebook or anywhere, whether you're using any site, this Grammarly works all over there. Also using the Google Docs and other Google features as well. So suppose I'm writing an email here, and let me get some content, say, let me get some content related to Feynman. So okay, so this is some content related to Feynman. So let me just copy it and put it here. Okay, so you can see that Grammarly is active here, and it can give me suggestions while I am using my mail server. So it's giving me all the suggestions that I get, the same suggestions that I will be getting while I'm using Grammarly in the app.grammarly.com. Similarly, while I'm writing a message in WhatsApp, while writing a message in Facebook, or while making a document file on docs.google.com, Grammarly is active still there. Okay, so that's all about Grammarly. Now let me just head over to the third app that's there in the Grammarly. The third app is Grammarly for iPhone and iPad. So basically, if you're iPhone or iPad user, then you can install it your iPhone and iPad also, and then you can also install it on your Android also. So whatever mobile or tab you're using, you can install Grammarly on it and use in the similar way that you are using in your browser. So that's all about Grammarly. One more thing that I forgot to mention is that you can also check for plagiarism using Grammarly. So suppose I'm searching for Alexander Graham Bell, some content related to it. So here is some content related to Alexander Graham Bell on Wikipedia. So I'm just copying this much and just pasting it here. So I know that I have taken this content from Wikipedia. So when I will click on plagiarism, then you will see that it detects on its own that there is 100% plagiarism of this content that is from this particular site. Similarly, there is plagiarism check for all other the sites that's available in the open source in internet. So basically, you can check against the content that you have created, and you can make sure that your content is 100% unique by reducing the plagiarism to zero. All right, so that's all about Grammarly. That's it. Thank you.